Hey everyone, Rodney here at Cleves Tech, and today I'm going to show you a useful add-on for Focus, the Focus Log Viewer, which is basically the Focus Log on steroids. Now, if you're not familiar with Focus, it's just another stable diffusion UI for generating images. It's a lot easier to use than some of the other ones, so if you're not familiar, I do have plenty of other videos that cover that. The default Focus has a log that you can go into. You can click on the history log, and that'll bring you to here. And if you go into the individual folders, you can go to past days, you can look through your images and see everything you have. But if you have a lot of images, it can take a while to scroll through all those, and it's kind of time consuming. And searching and everything else, you can't do any of that sort of stuff easily unless you use built-in browser functions going back. So that's where this comes into play. The Focus Log Viewer gives you more options because, for one thing, it's not just on the day that you currently have open. We now can actually switch between different days and go back to any day that we want in our history and view the files that are in that folder. Now, besides the regular calendar view, which has its benefits and you can go through each day, I find this one up here, the calendar icon, if you click on that, is a little bit better because that's going to only show you the days that you have images for. And if you wanted to, you can just click on that specific day to go to that day. And then you can go through and view all the images just like you would otherwise. So that's my preferred calendar view, but you can do it on here as well. Now, the other options you have up at the top are the sound on an image. So every time an image is generated, you're going to get an audio alert. And then you have the auto reload as well. The one thing you will know, I will show you, is while you're generating and you're in this view, you will actually get a preview of the image as it pops up and gets generated. And you'll get the sound as well. I don't currently have my audio recording from the desktop, so you're not going to hear that sound, but when that image pops up and when it's done, we're going to get an alert on the right, and then it should auto reload after a short period of time. I'm not sure what that's set on, if it's on a new image or not. You also do have at the top here, we have a search function. So if we type on, go on that, we can go into here and type what we're looking for. And we're going to get the results. You can also search by models and styles. You can also search just by those. So if you wanted to find something that just used a certain style, you could search just for that style. That's one of the more powerful features to me. Those between the date and the search that make this much more useful. But you also just the format and layout and everything else as well. Now, up here at the top, we have the mode between images and batches. Images just shows you each image and each, and it breaks it down by batch. But if you go to the batch mode, then you can scroll through each batch at a time. I suppose if you do very large batches, that might be a preferred way of doing it. I normally use it in the image mode. You can change the number of images that you have per page. The order, I think, is pretty obvious, the order that it's going to show it. Now, these two here seem to, the differential won't do anything if you turn on diff, but if you hit batch details, it's going to show the details for each batch here, all your pertinent information. It'll display the styles with the little preview image and everything. Now, if you hit the diff button here, what happens is it's going to show you the difference between the previous batch. So we can look at this and we know that the previous batch below this had a different styles. Well, it didn't have different styles. It had a different model, had a different lure, things like that. Down the bottom left corner here, you're going to have the option to increase or decrease the size of the images on the bottom left here. So those are all the features of the main interface that you have there. Now, once you click on the images, you can just get all the metadata just by clicking on copy. When you hover over it, you can also download the image by just clicking on the button to download it. But if we go into the actual images on here, so we have a much better way to view the images, and we can cycle through them one at a time and we can see them much bigger. You also can copy specific details So if you want to still copy it all, you can click copy all the clipboard, just like the regular log. But if you want to just copy the prompt and not anything else, we could do that as well. And then we can go in here and we could paste it and generate. Of course, just like the regular log, we can copy all the metadata to the clipboard. And then you can just paste it into there, load the parameters, and everything's back in. That works the same way as the regular log does. No different there. But it does make it a lot easier to navigate. It has all your pertinent information that you're looking for. And it definitely makes it a lot easier to navigate through your images and see what they look like. I found I used to use built-in like photo apps and stuff like that to view my images because I didn't like the log well. But I find now that I'm starting to use this more and more, I use this almost all the time because this just makes it a lot easier to go through all my images that I've generated and everything. Okay, so you're probably wondering, where do you get this wonderful piece of software? Well, it's actually very easy. It's called the Focus Log Viewer, and I will include a link to the GitHub page in the description. I believe, so this is done by this guy, TJS, all JavaScript, if my French is correct, but I'm not positive. Anyways, I think this was taken, somebody else created it and he improved upon it, and that's where we're at. I don't know the details on all that. So once you're on this page, all we need to do, and he does walk through how everything works for the most part, as I've described. We go over here to the releases. You can just go into there and the latest release here. If you want to go back to a previous one, you can go back, grab a previous release if you want to, but we're going to grab the latest one. I'll go ahead and download this into my test install here. And let's see here. Now, once I have those downloaded, I'm just gonna extract everything right to this folder here. How you do this is up to you. You just need to extract those files. Now, once we have those extracted, we're gonna copy these to the viewer and two viewer files, the HTML and the JavaScript. We're just going to take that, and you can copy, paste, whatever you want to do. And then you're going to go into your focus folder. So for me in here, and then find your outputs folder. Now, if you have your folder, outputs folder going to a separate location, you can't just put that in that folder and have it work. I'll show you how to do that in a moment. But if this is if you just have the default install and you have your files being saved in here. Now, if you have this already set up with a symbolic link or something like that, you can do it that way as well. So once we're in our outputs folder in this top level directory, not the individual days, we're just gonna paste those in there. And that's all there is to that. And now we're technically, it's all set up and installed to work. So I'm gonna go ahead at this point and let's get Focus up and running. You do need Focus running for this to work. Now, once you have that up and running, this is the easiest way. If you don't want to modify anything or anything like that, go into your outputs folder once you have it all set up. And we can go ahead and launch this is the easiest way. Now, when you first launch it, it's going to come up to this page because we're not going to the correct folder. But this is the easiest way to actually get the default location where it's going to be. Depending on which port number you're running it on, the default is 7865. So if we just click on here, it'll bring up, and now we have our link. If we look up here, this is the actual link to go to it. It's just like with regular focus log, you get the same idea up here. It works the same way. Let me bring that back up. So at this point, if you want to just use it that way and you don't want to edit the code for Focus to integrate it, you can just bookmark this at this point, save that bookmark location so the next time you load it, you don't have to do what I just showed you. That will be the exact location that that will work. Now, if you want to integrate it into Focus so you have the links down here, you can do that. This does edit the code in Focus. So I do recommend being careful when doing this. If you're not sure what to do, in all honesty, I wouldn't. I don't use it this way. I just create the bookmark myself. I don't find any need to have it integrated myself because anytime you update Focus or anything like that, it's either gonna break this integration, or it could even block Focus from updating. As he explains, the first step is if you just drop it in there, that'll work, and then you can just use the link. If you want to integrate it in, you have to change this add one line to Focus for it to work. We're going to go into our modules, and then we want the UI Gradio extension. Now, how you edit this is up to you. I'm just going to use Notepad++. You can use whichever you want. I find something like this is easier because you'll know where to edit it. So as we can see here, these are all the lines it says on line 43. Copy that. And then in here, hit Tab. I'll paste it in there. And then I'm going to hit Save. It won't work until you restart Focus. So let's go ahead and restart Focus. Now, if we go into Focus, you're going to have two options down here at the bottom. Well, I guess we get the iframe, so you can bring it into here. Ha! I hadn't tried that before, because I don't integrate it. So I guess you can do it all inside of here. We can close that. Or you can just bring up new tab and bring the viewer up. And that's all there is to integrating into Focus, but do keep in mind that does change the code. If Focus updates, you're going to have to redo that. And it may not even work when Focus updates. That's the other thing to keep in mind with this, is if something changes in Focus to make this not work, the person needs to update that code. So if you want to stop Focus from updating, you can do that, but I'm not going to cover that in this video. Now, if you're like me and you have your Focus output to a separate folder, that's going to be a little bit different. You're going to have to set up a symlink for that if you haven't already. If you have, it's not an issue. You can just drop those files in just like normal. So for me, this is my output folder. I've already put these two files in here like I did with the other folder, but it's still not going to work because the way that it's set up, I still have the outputs folder here and there's nothing in it. So that's not going to work that way. What I want to do at that point is first, since we're not using this folder, I'm going to go ahead and delete that. Now, there we go. Delete. So we've deleted that folder now. And then what I can do here is I'm going to hit, Windows key X to bring up my menu. And I'm going to open a command prompt with administrator rights. You do need to have administrator rights to do this. So I'm going to click on that. So you're going to use the mklink. /D, and then you're going to put the output folder here. This is the original outputs folder that we had. That's the one that I just deleted, because if you try to do this and that folder is still already there, it won't generate it. So we have to remove the folder first, because that's going to create a new folder here with a link, a symbolic link to the actual folder. So the second one is the actual folder where my images are saved. So for me, that's this drive up here, and that's the address for that. And then this one was, I have my in my F drive, then I have Focus, and then Focus, and then the outputs folder is in there. You do want it spelt exactly that way, because it's got to be just like the original one that was in there. Now, once we have that all set, I can just hit enter. And when I hit enter, you're going to see it's going to create a new folder here with a link on it. And as I said, this has to be in administrator mode. You can't do it in just the regular command prompt. When we hit enter, there we go. Symbolic link created. And if we go into here, you'll notice it now has the outputs folder with just a shortcut link, as it looked like. But if we click on that, it still looks like it's in the Focus folder now. But that's still the other folder I have. And I now have my files in here, so this will work. So now if we go ahead, let me launch Focus here. Now I'll go into my folder like I did before, because I do still want to, since I'm not going to be integrating this on mine, this is how I do mine. And then I can go into here, pull that up. I'm going to get this one to default at first. I'll click on my link. Now that brings it up. And now I have my link, and I can bookmark that, which I've already bookmarked it. So that's how you would do it if you have it in a separate folder and you haven't already set up a symbolic link to do all that sort of stuff. You can do it that way. Now, If you run this inside of other tools like Stability Matrix or anything like that, you will have to do a similar thing with theirs. I'm not gonna cover that in this video, but you'll have to do the same idea to get that to work in there, but it will work. That covers everything for today. If you found this video helpful, please consider hitting that like button so others may have a chance to find the video as well. If interested in helping support the channel, I do have a Patreon, and also you could buy me a cup of coffee if you want instead. And thanks to the people who have supported me up to this point. The links are in the description. I'm currently working on a custom GPT with ChatGPT as a focus assistant and hope to share more info on that soon. Thanks for watching and have fun creating.